That's a wrap.
Insert video here. First off, we have our ENG report from Taryn. He is doing the medical careers, so we'll go ahead and check in with Taryn. Taryn, what's going on with medical careers, man?
Now we're going to have some movie reviews with Emily and Emma.
So you're sitting home alone, bored, nothing to do. You pick up the phone and call your bro. Here's an example. Hey, bro.
Hey, what up, girl?
What you doing today?
Not much. What you doing?
Oh, I'm just chilling. You want to see a movie with me?
Sure. What time?
How about 9?
Sounds good.
Now you have something to do tonight. So hey, my name is Emily. I'm obsessed with movies, one of which in particular called Pitch Perfect is what I'm here to talk to you about. Pitch Perfect is about a girl named Becca who is the new girl on campus. She can't find any clubs on campus that she would have any desire to be a part of until she is cornered by a girl in the shower. This girl in particular heard Becca singing and wanted her to join the campus's all-girls a cappella group named the Bellas. Becca basically can't say no because this girl would not leave her alone in the shower until she said yes. The Bellas' rivals on campus are the Troublemakers. The Troublemakers basically think they're the hottest thing on campus. Becca meets this boy named Jesse. They slowly start to fall for each other throughout this movie. But there's a strict rule that a Bella can't be with any of the Troublemakers. When it's time for the finals, everyone expects the Bellas to do the reprisal of their same old boring routine. But the Bellas surprise everyone with a brand new routine filled with titillating dance moves complete with Fat Amy ripping her shirt off.
Hey, I'm Emma, and I recently just saw a film called Perks of Being a Wallflower, and it's based off a novel by Stephen Chbosky. It's a story about a 15-year-old freshman in high school named Charlie, and focuses around him and him getting through his first year of high school and dealing with making new friends, having his first love, and dealing with his own mental illness and the suicide of his best friend. I personally love this film. I thought it was shot beautifully and has potential to be a classic. It was very relatable. Everybody personally knows a Sam and a Patrick and a Charlie, and all are very memorable and endearing. They threw in twists that were unexpected and made you stay interested in the plot. Though it has a bit of a dark undertone, this makes it far more interesting than any movie I've seen recently. It's only in selected theaters, so when it comes to your town, make sure to get tickets as soon as possible.
All right, so this has been Emily.
And Emma.
And these were our movie reviews. Have a great day.
Now we're moving on to some more movie reviews, but this one is a top 5 countdown of the scariest movies from past years.
His body was never recovered from the lake after he drowned.
He was a filthy child murderer who killed at least 20 kids in the neighborhood.
I met him 15 years ago. I was told there was nothing left. No reason.
Hello, fellow horror movie lovers. This is Big Bird Shaggy, a.k.a. Chancey Schilling, and this is...
MLG, a.k.a. MLG. I know, this is weird, huh?
And this is...
Top 5 Horror Movies of the 70s and 80s.
First on our list was a legend that led to 6 sequels and 2 remakes.
That's right, folks. It's Halloween.
Halloween came out in 1978 and was directed by John Carpenter.
This movie also came out 6 days before Halloween. I know, scary, right? Also featuring Jamie Lee Curtis, which is a hot chick. Our next movie is The Thing, another great classic movie made in 1982 by John Carpenter, also featuring Kurt Russell. This movie is about an alien creature thing that can take the form of anybody. Anybody.
Run away, run away! Next on our list was also a legend that led to 7 sequels, 1 remake, and a collaboration with another killer.
That's right. Freddy Krueger, a man who can kill you even in your dreams.
This movie came out in 1984 with famous horror movie director
Wes Craven.
Nice.
Almost there, and here's number 2.
That's right, Stanley Kubrick's The Shining, made in 1980 starring Jack Nicholson, which he in this movie creeped everyone out in the 80s with his famous line,
"Here's Johnny."
Now, here's the number 1 movie made in the 70s. It is The Exorcist, made in 1973.
This movie was based off a real exorcism that supposedly happened to a little boy who had demonic possessions, but yet changed the world in horror in that time.
Well, that's been the top 5 horror movies of the 70s and 80s.
Thank you guys for watching.
Peace.
Now a public service announcement from Izzy.
Now we're going over to Michael with another ENG report. Michael, what's going on, man?
Now we have Elijah with holiday tips and a Veterans Day video.
In a world where there's nothing else to drink besides disgusting milk and boring old water, one drink destroys the competition.
Hey, what's up? What's wrong with you, man? I'm so thirsty. I need something.
Oh no.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh yeah!
Drink Kool-Aid!
Hi everyone, I'm Elijah Tipman here with
Emma Magsman.
We hope you enjoyed your Halloween. If you didn't, well, at least you didn't make my mistake in wearing a pinata costume. Okay, it was just a photo. Let's move to Thanksgiving, shall we? President Abraham Lincoln officially made Thanksgiving a national holiday in 1863.
Did you know American Thanksgiving commemorates pilgrims from England surviving their first brutal New England winter?
Duh. Here's some advice. If you're hosting dinner, make at least one dish for vegetarians.
Or don't invite vegetarians, those tree-hugging losers.
Okay. When cooking the turkey, check it regularly with a meat thermometer. The turkey should reach a final temperature of 180 degrees in the thigh.
Make sure it's the meat thermometer and not the one you just had in here. Sure.
After dinner, it's wise.
Yes?
Oh, I was using the word, not your name.
Oh, that's okay. Happens all the time. Keep up the good work.
Okay. She's crazy.
I heard that.
My bad. After dinner, it's smart to have fun family games.
If you don't have board games, get some paper and a hat. Play charades.
Hope these tips will help you have a successful Thanksgiving Day celebration.
I hope it's full of fun, food, families, love, food, memories, food.
And yeah, I knew you were going to say food. On behalf of all of us at Insert Video here,
Happy Thanksgiving.
And now we're going to my sketch. It's XD with me and Chansey.
Woo!
Gangnam Style!
Oh yeah!
That dance we just did seems pretty ridiculous, am I right?
Ridiculous or not, it was made famous by a Korean pop artist named Psy.
Psy? What kind of name is that? I mean, what's he got, a couple thousand views on this thing?
Ha! Try like 500 million views as of this episode.
That's more than Charlie bit my finger. I mean, how is that possible?
Exactly. Don't hate on my man Psy and his 4 million plus likes.
Whatever, man. Here's a clip, I guess. 이때다 싶으면 묶었던 머리 푸는 여자 가렸지만 웬만한 노출보다 야한 여자 그런 감각적인 여자 나는 선어해 점잖아 보이지만 놀 때 노는 선어해 내가 되면 완전 미쳐버리는 선어해 You don't wanna say 오빤 강남 스타일
Gangnam Style.
You know, man, video is pretty tight. I mean, Psy does have some swag that I guess I just never experienced before.
Well, anyways, that's all we have for you guys today. Keep calm and laugh on. Brandon?
Have some quick fashion tips with me.
walking round a zoo with the sun shining down over me and you. And there'll be love in the bodies of the elephants too. And I'll put my hands over your eyes, but you'll peek through. And there'll be sun, sun, sun all over our bodies. And sun, sun, sun all down the necks. And there'll be sun, sun, sun.
And last but not least, we're going to have three game reviews from Sean, Emily, and Chansey.
Go left, bro.
No.
Go right. Go right.
Dude, what are you guys doing? We have a show to do.
Dude, we got this.
Yeah, we totally got this.
All right, you guys ready then?
Yeah.
All right, then. It's time to review today's top hit games.
Track!
What's up, bros and sisters? I'm Sean.
I'm Chansey, like that thing off Pokemon.
And I'm Emily, the blonde gamer girl with a nice face.
And this is Nerd Alert. Chansey, would you like to kick off our first episode?
Yes. I'll start our first episode off with Max Payne 3. This game is unapologetically very violent. In fact, it lingers on violence, but not all the time. It focuses on some most visceral manifestations: ragged bullet wounds, charred flesh, and dismembered limbs. But it also peers into the unseen causes that lie behind such acts of violence. Single player story lasts around 10 to 12 hours, depending on how long you play it. Max Payne 3 has a variety of arcade modes, from score challenges to speedruns to keep you busy once you finish the main story. It's multiplayer, that's the really surprising part, however. It's gleeful pandemonium. Gang Wars, in particular, attempts something rather ambitious, trying to weave narrative into what is usually a player-determined mode. Players aren't at the liberty to roam, to explore, or shake anything up. I would give this game about 5 nerd points because it's awesome and the multiplayer is even more awesome.
Alright, thanks, Chansey. How about you, Emily? Any games you want to review?
Yeah, sure. I'm the blonde with the nice face. I'm a girl that is obsessed with video games that deal with dragons. Yeah, I eat, sleep, and slay dragons. I think about this game constantly. Skyrim is a role-playing game that takes place in the realm of Skyrim, obviously. Skyrim is a 5th installment of the Elder Scrolls series. It started out with Arena for the PC and then came Daggerfall. Skyrim has 2 add-ons so far. The first one was Dawnguard. In Dawnguard, you either become a vampire or fight vampires. But FYI, if you choose to not become a vampire, you still have to become one eventually. The third add-on is going to be released on December 4th and is called Dragonborn. I just heard about this today and I freaked out. Anyways, I give Skyrim 4.9 nerd points out of 5. Don't ask. Now remember this: guns don't kill people. Lag kills people.
Great review and quote, Emily. I guess I'll finish things off with this episode. I'm going to talk about the newest installment in a growing franchise. That's right, I'm talking about Assassin's Creed 3. Assassin's Creed 3 was just released October 30th and is one of the most anticipated games this holiday season. Now, we're going to look into some of the actual gameplay and check out some of the new features. First off, we're going to talk about how you can now hone your skills for the perfect assassination. As Connor, you'll learn tricks and trade of assassination through this new free-running system, which makes it easier to run through crowds in and out, so you won't trip and fall over people and get caught by local guards. You also have changes in how you fight the guards, local thugs, and for the first time ever, wild animals. I'm talking about deers, bears, antelopes, and everything else in the new frontier. Everything in AC3 is beautifully rendered to give amazing viewpoints of early America. Also, they redone the multiplayer servers, giving you more options such as Wolfpack, Capture the Artifact, and many, many more. I would give this game 4.5 nerd points. That's just me. Pick up your copy of AC3 at your local retailer for about $60 or more. And for those that pre-ordered Assassin's Creed, pick it up by December 1st to get a 10% off. That's right, 10% off the official guide to help you get 100% customization and many more tips. Well, that's our show for today, folks.
Finally.
And we made it without killing each other.
Yay!
So thank you guys for watching this episode of Insert Video Here. I'm Brandon.
I'm Emma.
And we'll see you guys later. That's a wrap.
La donna è mobile, qual più malavento, muta l'accento, vedi pensiero, se è un amabile leggiadro viso, in bianco il viso, e ben sognero, la donna è mobile, qua più malo è netto.